Life begins with someone calling you. A cry that is loud, sudden, and explosive. This is what we generally would expect out of maternity wards. A normal pregnancy ending into a normal delivery where mother and child both are safe. A mother goes through a roller coaster of feelings during her pregnancy. Sometimes she is super happy. Sometimes she is super anxious. Sometimes it is a bit of a surprise for her. But to me, personally, even if I cannot put all these feelings into words, one feeling stands out, and it is at the top of this chart. A feeling of relief. A relief mother experiences when she knows her baby is safe. A relief when she knows her 9-month journey has ended into a positive outcome. It is the same relief she experiences when she knows and hears her baby's cry for the first time. It is the same relief which gives her a joy when she knows her baby is waiting to enter into a realm of real world. But sometimes this wait gets longer. Sometimes babies do not cry. Whatever mother used to feel during her 9-month journey is not happening anymore. She is told that baby has no heartbeat, that the skin turned pale and whiter, that the fingers don't open. There is deafening silence. Baby could die without crying. Mother is anxious. She feels somehow some miracle to happen which will reverse the situation. She waits for the doctor. Doctor comes, checks the pulse rate, checks the heartbeat, checks the breathing of the baby. Mother cannot believe it. Baby is not moving. Mother wants him to recheck the baby. Doctor does that. Our mother is still not satisfied. She wants second opinion. Another doctor comes. He confirms, reconfirms. Baby is not moving. The hope for a mother to listen to the cry of her baby is not going to happen. And this is not just a narrative. This has happened for real. This happened in a taluka place, Parali in Maharashtra, 5 years back. We witnessed a mother coming to the hospital in a panic situation, and during her delivery, because of excess bleeding, she delivered a stillbirth. The episode of crisis led her to rush to the hospital, which was as away as 8 hours from Parali in a different state in Hyderabad. During this transition period from one place to another, there was a risk that mother could also die. But to her help, there was a doctor friend who was in constant touch with that ambulatory service over phone. It was the doctor's advice which led us to monitor her blood pressure, heartbeat, and other critical parameters. That suggestion saved that mother's life. However, we could not save her baby in the first place. Aftermath of this incident taught us that there is possibility of some form of remote monitoring which will stop such deaths. Well, some ideas do come through eureka moments. However, most of them do come through accidents. Episode of crisis made us and compelled us to develop something for remote monitoring, which will keep these doctors and mothers connected, which will help reduce such deaths. This is when we realized we have to work on this problem. As an engineer, we had limited background in medical field, and that is why we needed cleaner and sharper inputs.
We came across a few similar cases with mothers having complications. And then we had a series of meetings with midwives, nurses, gynecologists, doctors, and even mothers. And we learned that there are the major causes of mortality and morbidity, which is deaths and disease, at the time of childbirth can be linked to the extremely irregular and inadequate monitoring of very basic clinical parameters in the months of pregnancy. For example, hemoglobin, blood pressure, blood sugar, fetal distress, and infection. We also learned that prenatal care or pregnancy care has a far greater value attached to it than what we know or what has been described traditionally in research. If we zoom out and look at the larger problem, India has reduced the numbers of deaths in mothers or the maternal mortality over the last decade or so. But like any other average, this is going to hide the differences between the states of India. There are states like Maharashtra, Kerala, that have made significant improvements. And there are 9 other states with extremely high maternal mortality to the point that they contribute 12% of the total global burden. And yet, the problem is not restricted to the numbers of deaths. It's about the severe health morbidities that take place in the newborn, notably low birth weight and prematurity. These two alone pose a long-term risk to the health of the child. Can any of this be avoided and prevented? Can several of this be better managed? Definitely. But how do we do that? To begin with, the vast majority of pregnant women in India must receive a minimum package of antenatal care services. This includes 3 components: at least 100 tablets of iron and folic acid, at least 4 visits for health checkups to doctors, and more if there are complications, and 2 tetanus injections. Much minimalist and minimum as this sounds, this requires an enormous public health effort, an enormous amount of training of health workers, and enormous awareness creation. Why? Because statistics again tell us that 20% of pregnant women in India, and yes, only 20% as of 2018, receive this minimum package, which ironically is called as complete antenatal care. Going ahead with this is where the point at which our role began, because we thought of trying to bring the clinic close to the client if the client cannot make it to the clinic. And this became the seed of an idea that germinated under the umbrella of CareNX Innovations, took its shape by 2015. We termed it Care Mother. Bridging the access gap between the doctor on one hand and the mother and her child in waiting on the other is at the core of this idea. Since its inception, our teams have been tirelessly working to ensure that any difficult situation in pregnancy or in labor is tackled by expert medical advice, either remotely or in person, to prevent the loss of life, and more commonly, to prevent the occurrence of the morbidities. To me, Care Mother appears like a melting pot of realities. May I ask, what are realities? Realities are known to us. Realities are things we sometimes take for granted. Realities are things which we don't channelize enough. They appear self-sustaining, so we probably don't understand their full potential. And for the most part, they remain existing like scattered facts and thoughts in our heads. We just learned that prenatal care is a reality and a very important one, and very, very relevant one for all mothers. The other one is the penetration of smartphones across the length and breadth of India, and the fact that they have completely eliminated the information gap. A third reality, very special to India, is the huge cadre of community-based health workers that deliver public health services at the doorstep. India is home to 600,000 midwives and nurses and 1 million ASHA workers who deliver the healthcare, and thereby they bring the clinic close to the client. Today, Care Mother is a mobile antenatal care solution which identifies risk factors in pregnancy as early as possible, that is within the first 3 to 6 months of pregnancy. And in doing so, the diagnostics at the doorstep becomes 10 times cheaper than the expenses incurred in the infrastructure of a pathology lab. That apart, families tend to put more trust and confidence in this process because it's right in their homes, and tend to support our cause, which generates our social currency. Care Mother consists of a diagnostic kit, a portable diagnostic kit, which is like a clinic inside a box, and a smartphone application driven by an algorithm that can identify high-risk pregnancies, generate a list of mothers who require attention, and report results to doctors in real time. It has three mobile components embedded: the mobile phone, the mobile health worker, and the portable diagnostic kit. Technology not only saves time and resources, but also relays accurate results to decision makers and to no one else in the process. The doctor gets the result, and the interpretation goes promptly. That apart, the infusion of smartphones across social strata and the fact that there are huge numbers of community health workers bridges social barriers. The traditionally disadvantaged groups who are left out of intervention start to receive intervention. The market becomes more unified and homogenized. And that kind of a situation puts greater confidence in government stakeholders, non-government stakeholders, investors, to support the cause of delivering healthcare in this model. Today, the idea of connecting mothers with the health system has led to Care Mother being implemented in 9 different states of India in urban, rural, and tribal regions. We have identified and registered more than 22,000 pregnant women. Identified more than 12,000 high-risk pregnancies, which in fact is 33% more than the routine systems of surveillance. We have managed to do all of this through a team of extremely involved and hardworking 260 community health workers. And that apart, we have achieved some stability in key medical parameters. I'll give an example. In the city of Mumbai, in an urban slum, we conducted a sub-study on a proportion of pregnant women who were classified as high risk in the beginning of pregnancy. By 2 weeks before their delivery, they had substantially reduced their risk. And in the intervening period, it can all be attributed to the follow-ups, the notifications, the home visits, the repeated communication that happened. We want these results to occur in other areas, and we hope for that. We have a vision to create a platform that every mother can use and personalize for the best antenatal care possible, and to take charge of her own health by access to doctors, so that the childbirth outcomes are better for both the mother and the child. We dream that every mother and her unborn baby is connected to a responsive health system through tools which are as efficient as possible and accurate. We want every mother and her unborn child to gain out of this system so that life ahead is safe and secure, because now we are clear that health outcomes after delivery depend so much on what happens in pregnancy. And we know this dream is ambitious and larger than life. But we are delighted that steps have been taken already. Until the last year, we were focusing on bridging the access gap. But now we are directing the research and the development teams to design very specific clinical innovations. The first is something called as the uterine activity monitor. Now, what this does is it measures the electrical activity in the muscle of the uterus, which always precedes the actual contraction. So it's very sensitive and accurate. It has the capacity to detect the chances of premature birth. Not only that, it can identify fetal distress, or simply put, the disturbance in the baby's heartbeat in the womb. These and other additions are going to make our platform way more customized and attuned to the ever-growing needs of clients and doctors. We also have designed a very refined and precise fetal heart rate monitor, which also measures fetal distress. Now, when we develop these innovations, we never realize the social implications that they can have. For instance, the baby's heartbeat is the only silent connection, perhaps the biggest silent connection, between the mother and the child in a limited interaction during pregnancy. And today, because the fetal heart rate monitor is based on ultrasound Doppler, not only the mother, but even the family members are able to hear the baby's heartbeat, and they become more involved in the process. So a device which was constructed as a medical support is now being used by the community health worker in the setting of a home, received by the mother, and observed by the family members to create a collective, immersive experience of listening to a baby's heartbeat, the same heartbeat that we discussed in the very beginning.
While the life has been full of surprises when we started working in this space, some of them are good, some of them are bad. Today, I wish to conclude by sharing one such a pleasant surprise. So there is a health worker, we name her C, C being a champion, who is from our own city of Gates, Aurangabad. She has been associated with us since 2013 and cared for more than 2,000 women, starting from 12 different villages to 40 different villages around Aurangabad. Because of her noticeable work, she was invited by Tata Institute of Social Sciences in Mumbai to talk before a panel of experts from public health. She went there, she published her paper, and also gave a talk. So this acknowledgement gave her a social recognition. The flip side of the story is she was a victim of domestic violence. But just because of this acknowledgement, her family's passion towards her turned, and they accepted her more gracefully and more happily. Now she has become an idol in her community. The point I want to make is not only health outcomes, but also a social currency is very important. And this is where we stand. We don't realize when our own effort of helping others have come for our own salvation. A small idea of creating a remote monitoring platform has turned into an ecosystem where mothers and doctors can be connected. Starting from a small pilot in Aurangabad, right up to going to a Buckingham Palace, meeting Queen of England and getting recognition, all that was possible because of our ground level soldiers. And as a creator of Care Mother, we could not ask for more. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.